Dear students of class 7, welcome to you all. I like to discuss today the new topic, third chapter, that is the Delhi Sultanate. The Delhi Sultan's rule began when the Muhammad Ghori attacked India and defeated Prithviraj Chauhan in the second battle of Talai in 1192. After his victory, the Turkish rule began in India. We know that he placed his own slave on the throne of Delhi, Qutbuddin Aibak. After defeating Prithviraj Chauhan, he captured Delhi and placed his own slave, most favored slave, Qutbuddin Aibak, on the throne of Delhi. Qutbuddin Aibak ruled from 1206 to 1210. Now, you see that thus the Sultanate rule began in India. Almost all the rulers of the Delhi Sultanate called themselves Sultan. And initially, and all during this period of Sultanate period, five dynasties ruled in India. Then, namely, Slave Dynasty, Khalji Dynasty, Tughlaq Dynasty, and Sayyid Dynasty, and Lodi Dynasty. Slave, Khalji, Tughlaq, Sayyid, and Lodi Dynasty. Almost altogether five dynasties rule in India. Now, Qutbuddin Aibak was a slave of Muhammad Ghori, and they were actually the dynasties, they are known as also Mamelukes. They are also known as Mameluk. Mameluk mean in Arabic words an individual owned by someone else. An individual owned by someone else is known as Mameluk. They are also known as Mamelukes, and they belong to the Ilbari tribe. Ilbari Turks, I-L-B-A-R-I-T-U-R-K-S, Ilbari Turks. However, Qutbuddin Aibak started and he was placed on the throne. Now he captured Delhi, Ajmer, Jhansi and Meerut. He was a powerful ruler and he was a very generous ruler, kind ruler. He was known as Lakh Box, or donor of lakhs. He was a great builder and patron of art and architecture. He built two mosques. Quwat-ul-Islam in Delhi and Alai Din Ka Jhopra in or at Ajmer. Alai Din Ka Jhopra at Ajmer. And the most important construction is started, the highest minar at that time, the Qutb Minar. Qutb Minar started by him, construction started. And it was later completed by Iltutmish. Now, you see that he died in the year 1210 while he was playing polo on horseback. He suddenly fell, so he died. And now he was succeeded by Aram Shah. Aram Shah was the Anwardi ruler, and naturally, at that time, Iltutmish, the most favorite slave of Qutbuddin Aibak, overthrew him or captured the power. Iltutmish ruled from 1211 to 1236 CE. He faced many challenges. What are the challenges? Challenges of the rebellion of the nobles within his territory. And attacks of the Mongols. However, he suppressed the rebellion of the nobles, and also he resisted the Mongol attack, defeated the Rajput rulers like Ujjain, Ranthambore, and also he faced challenge from rebellion from Lahore and Multan. By it was it is the from Lahore and Multan Nasiruddin Kubacha or Kubacha in book it is given only. Kubacha revolted, but Kubacha was defeated, and Lahore and Multan brought under his control. Moreover, he adopted the title Sultan-i-Azam. Iltutmish. Sultan-i-Azam. And he introduced the coins, like silver coins, that is currency reform made. Silver coins, Tanka, and copper coin, Jital, J-I-T-L. And most important thing is that in the field of architecture, he completed the construction of Qutub Minar, which was started by Qutubuddin Aibak during the reign of Iltutmish. The construction of Qutub Minar was completed. Now, he died in the year 1236, and before his death, he nominated Rajia, his daughter, as his successor. But the nobles did not accept her. So Ruknuddin Firoz Shah was placed on the throne. But however, he was unworthy. So Rajia revolted and overthrew his own brother and captured the power. However, Rajia faced many challenges, particularly opposition from a group of 40 nobles, Turkish nobles. Opposition from a group of 40 Turkish nobles, and also they are very military, they are also military leader, powerful military leader. They control the political affairs of Delhi or Sultanate Kingdom. However, with the help of his followers, Rajia captured the throne, and he was very courageous and brave. He all used to wear the main male dress and appeared in the court, and also herself led the army in the battlefield. But however, he is this type of manners, his actually appearance or dress like the male did not satisfy his own followers and nobles. They plotted against her, and ultimately she was killed. And although he was a very brave ruler, he ruled for only 4 years, 1236 to 40, only 4 years. After his death, you know that now Ghiyasuddin Balban came to the throne. Now after her death, Rajia's death, her younger brother Nasiruddin became the ruler. And on Nasiruddin was a very weak ruler, and the actual control was in the hands of his prime minister Ghiyasuddin Balban. Prime minister controlled the political affairs of the kingdom, and after the death of Nasiruddin, Ghiyasuddin Balban ascended the throne. Ghiyasuddin Balban was a very powerful ruler. He protected the kingdom from the Mongol attack. He also fortified the city and built many forts to resist the Mongol invasion. He ruled from 1266 to 1287. And he also is a very believed in the divine right kingship. That is, mean he thought he was the representative of God and ruling the kingdom as a representative of God, on behalf of God. However, in order to raise the dignity and power and prestige of the Sultan or Sultanate, he introduced the Persian customs like Sijda and Paibos. Sijda, actually prostrating, custom of prostrating before the emperor or Sultan. Paibos mon, meaning the kissing the feet of the Sultan. So these two Persian customs were introduced by him in order to raise the dignity of the Sultan, or power and dignity or prestige of the Sultan. Now, we see that ultimately after his death, the after his death, Kaikobad came to the throne, Kaikobad, but the Jalaluddin Khalji, one of the governor of Jalaluddin Khalji was the governor of Punjab, killed Kaikobad and and captured the power. And with this a new dynasty came, Khalji dynasty, which ruled from 1290 to 1316. The first ruler of the dynasty was Jalaluddin Khalji, who saved the kingdom from a Mongol attack. And also we see that he was very generous, and his nephew was Alauddin Khalji, and Alauddin Khalji was returning from the conquering the Devgiri of South India. He went to welcome him, but during this time Jalaluddin Khalji was assassinated by Alauddin Khalji. So after the death of Jalaluddin Khalji, Alauddin Khalji came to the throne, ruled from 1296 to 1316. He was one of the greatest very powerful ruler, and he captured many kingdoms of northern India, Gujarat, Chittor in Rajasthan, Ranthambore, Malwa, south, and also Ujjain, Mandu, Dhar and Chanderi. Similarly, you know that when he went to Gujarat, he captured many people, particularly slaves, and one of his slaves was a Hindu previously, Brahmin, was converted to Islamic religion, his name was Malik Kafur. Now Malik Kafur was later, became a very favorite general, and under his leadership of Malik Kafur, he sent an expedition to South India. And now he defeated one after another the Devgiris, the Hoysalas, Jadavas of Hoysalas, Devgiris, Kakatiyas, Warangal, and also he actually advanced up to Rameswaram, and he plundered the temples of Rameswaram, etc. So almost entire South India and Northern India brought under his control. Sultanate ruler who led an expedition towards the South India. And he established his empire up to the river Narmada. So next we see that the most important, he is chiefly remembered for his economic reforms. Although during his time Mongols attacked several times, he suppressed the Mongols and subdued them, and ultimately he raised a huge number of army. But in order to maintain the large number of army, he introduced several reforms. You see that the prices of the, he introduced the market regulations. The prices of the essential commodities were fixed, and also he imposed several types of revenues, and the soldiers were given, the armies were given in cash, not in land. And we know that some officials were appointed to supervise the market, and these officials supervise the market, and those who actually sold the goods above the market price, they were punished severely. And thus we see that these economic reforms Alauddin made a very, very important contribution. Moreover, in the administration, he also established a powerful centralized administration, and thus we see that Alauddin Khalji was the most powerful ruler of the Kalinga dynasty. Next day I will discuss, or I shall discuss the other rulers and dynasties. Thank you all.